Nearly 60 people are killed in a suicide bombing at a crowded mosque in Pakistan. More than 150 others were wounded. It's unclear how the bomber was able to enter the mosque, which is located inside a police compound in Peshawar city. Most of the casualties in the attack were police officers. A commander for the Pakistani Taliban claimed responsibility for the incident, but a spokesman for the group later denied any involvement. The World Health Organization retains its public health emergency declaration over the COVID pandemic. WHO Chief Tedros Ghebreyesus concurred with the advice offered by the UN Health Agency's Emergency Committee, which met last Friday. Prior to the meeting, Tedros had suggested that the emergency phase of the pandemic is not over. He cited the rising number of COVID deaths, adding that the global response to the crisis remains hobbled. The WHO first declared an emergency in January of 2020. The Philippine Justice Department inviting a UN special rapporteur to observe the government's probe of the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. This comes days after the International Criminal Court, or ICC, decided to reopen an investigation into the anti-drug campaign, saying Manila's own probe is insufficient. The Justice Department says it is open to a dialogue with the Hague-based tribunal and has invited UN Special Rapporteur on Extrajudicial Killings, Maurice Tedbal-Binns, to visit the Philippines next month. Meanwhile, President Marcos's chief legal counsel, Juan Ponce Enrile, warns he will move for the arrest of any ICC investigator who will set foot in the Philippines without the consent of the government.
As lawyer of the president, as far as I'm concerned, I will not recognize the jurisdiction of the International Criminal Court of Justice. They have no sovereign power over us. If they will come here, if I were to be followed, I will cause their arrest. They interfere too much with our internal affairs.
And really insists the actions of former President Rodrigo Duterte were within the bounds of the law.
The Philippine National Police Chief admits high-ranking officers with ties to drug trafficking were among senior officials who submitted their courtesy resignations this month. General Rodolfo Azurin Jr. says there were 11 of them who quit ahead of the January 31st deadline set by the Interior Secretary. Azurin adds most of the officials in question are retiring soon, but he touts the quit call as a success to cleanse the ranks of illegal drugs.
I see it more as a success because sabi ko nga, even yung mga supposedly na tinitingnan natin na under investigation, they allowed themselves na mag-submit sila ng courtesy resignation.
The chairman of the Philippine Senate Committee on Migrant Workers, Belize, claims the family of slain Filipino worker Julie B. Ranara has accepted blood money or is considering settlement with the camp of her alleged killer in Kuwait. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Nico Bagsik, who joins us now on the line. Nico, good morning. What more can you tell us?
Good morning, Mike. The family of slain OFW in Kuwait, Julie B. Granara, will not settle the case nor will accept blood money from the camp of the family of her alleged murderer. This is according to Senator Raffy Tulfo, head of Senate Committee on Migrant Workers, who made the statement after speaking with Granara's family last night. The issue of possible settlement has made the rounds over on social media, but the Ranara family is keen on upholding justice for the same family member.
Magkaisa po ang boses sila lahat, yung father, mother, at saka yung mister, na they will not accept blood money. The exact word of the father is dugo sa dugo. Ibig sabihin, justisya. Buhay kapalit ng buhay. So, kung ang parusa ay bitay, bitay, so be it. At hindi sila makikipag-areglo.
Senator Tulfo also called the public to stop spreading wrong information about blood money which was allegedly received by the Ranara's family because those were false accusations. Among other politicians and government officials who visited Ranara's wake in Las Piñas yesterday were President Marcos Jr., who promised to talk to the Kuwaiti government on improving the protection of OFWs there. Senator Bongo and Secretary for Migrant Workers, Toots Ople, also visited yesterday.
We are also scheduling bilateral meetings with Kuwait to look at the agreement that we have, to see if there are any weaknesses in the agreement that allowed this to happen, and to make sure that those weaknesses are remedied so that the agreement is stronger and will be more supportive of our workers, and furthermore that we hope this will never happen again.
Other families, friends, and relatives of Ranara family continue to come to the wake of Jollibee to extend their condolences. Security remains strict at the wake following the Ranara's request for privacy during this time of grieving. Back to you, Mike.
Thank you for that update, Nico Bagsik.